Hello and welcome to my channel Study with Delnaz. Today we will be discussing about MacGregor's Theory X and Theory Y of Motivation. This is the introduction of MacGregor's Theory X and Theory Y of Motivation. So Douglas MacGregor is a social psychologist and he developed two contrasting theories that explained that how managers believe about what motivates their people can affect their management style. So, he has labeled these theories as Theory X and Theory Y. Theory X and Theory Y were explained by MacGregor in the book The Human Side of Enterprise. They refer to two styles of management. First one is authoritarian, which he has labeled it as Theory X, and participative, meaning Theory Y. If you believe that your team members dislike their work and have little motivation, then according to MacGregor, you are likely to use an authoritarian style of management. This approach is very hands-on and usually involves micromanaging. Micromanaging means minutely controlling people. Micromanaging people's work to ensure that it gets done properly. And MacGregor has tagged this authoritarian style of management as Theory X. But if the manager believes that its people take pride in their work and see it as a challenge, then you're more likely to adopt a participative management style. Managers who use this approach trust their people to take ownership of their work and do it effectively by themselves. MacGregor has tagged this participative management style as Theory Y. We'll now take a more in-depth look at the two different theories and discover how and when they can be useful in the workplace. Now, let us understand the characteristics of Theory X in detail. Theory X managers tend to take a pessimistic view. A pessimistic view meaning a negative view of their people and assume that they are naturally unmotivated and dislike work. And because of this, they think that the team members need to be prompted, rewarded, or maybe punished constantly to make sure that they complete their tasks. According to MacGregor, organizations with a Theory X approach tend to have several ties of managers and supervisors to oversee and direct workers. Authority is rarely delegated and control remains firmly centralized. Managers are more authoritarian and actively intervene to get things done. This style of management assumes that workers dislike their work, avoid responsibility, need constant direction, have to be controlled, forced, threatened or punished to deliver work, need to be supervised at every step, have no incentive to work or no ambition to work. Although Theory X has fallen out of fashion in recent times, but still sometimes big organizations find it unavoidable due to the sheer number of people that they employ and the tight deadlines that they have to meet. Now let us understand Theory Y in detail. If in Theory X, the managers had a pessimistic view for their employees, in Theory Y, managers have an optimistic, positive opinion of their people and they use a decentralized, participative management style. And Theory X was authoritarian management style. This encourages a more collaborative, trust-based relationship between managers and employees. People have greater responsibility and managers encourage them to develop their skills and suggest improvements because they actually encourage creativity and innovation. Appraisals are regular, but unlike in Theory X organization, they are used to encourage open communication rather than to control the staff. Theory Y organizations also gives employees frequent opportunities for promotion. Theory Y has become more popular among organizations. So, what are the characteristics of theory Y. So this style assumes that the workers are happy to work on their own initiative. So they are happy to work, more involved in decision making, self-motivated to complete their tasks, enjoy taking ownership of their work, seek and accept responsibility, and need very little direction. View work as fulfilling and challenging, and they are very much satisfied with their work. Solves problems creatively and imaginatively. Why they can have a creative problem solving nature? Because they are not micromanaged like the way they are done in theory X. This reflects workers' increasing desire for more meaningful careers that provide them with more than just money. Theory X and Theory Y in the workplace. So how practically are you going to apply Theory X and Theory Y in your workplace? So most managers will likely use a mixture of Theory X and Theory Y. However, sometimes managers may favor one over the other. So you might, for instance, have the tendency to micromanage, or sometimes you have the tendency to have a more hands-off approach. So when I say micromanage, which theory are you following? You're following Theory X. And if I say hands-off approach, then you are following Theory Y. If I say hands-on approach, then you are following Theory X. So although both these management styles can motivate people, the success of each will largely depend on your team's needs and wants and your organizational objectives. So based on the needs and wants of your team and its organizational objectives, based on that, you can decide whether Theory X should be used or Theory Y should be used. You may use a Theory X style of management for new starters who will likely need a lot of guidance or in a situation that requires you to control, right, in case of crisis. So if there are new starters who have joined your organization, so you can use Theory X on them, because of course they will be they will require a lot of guidance, and you can possibly control their activities also because they are unaware about most of the things. But you don't use it when you're managing a team of experts who are used to working under their own initiative and need little direction. So this same Theory X cannot be used to manage a team of experts, because they are already expert in their work, they know their work well, and they usually have their own initiative and they need very little direction, because as we know, they are experts. But still, if you used Theory X to manage a team of experts, then it would likely have a demotivating effect and may even damage your relationship with them. The restrictive nature of Theory X could cause people to become demotivated and non-cooperative if your approach is too strict. This may lead to high staff turnover and could damage your reputation in the long run. But if you adopt Theory Y approach that gives people too much freedom, it may allow them to stray. Stray means stay away from their key objectives, and they may also possibly lose focus. Less motivated individuals may also take advantage of this more relaxed working environment by shirking their work, meaning neglecting their work. If this happens, the managers need to take back some control to ensure that everyone meets their team and organizational goals. So in conclusion, we can say that this approach, the approach that you take, have a significant impact on your ability to motivate your team members. So it's important to understand how your perceptions of what motivates them can shape your management style. Circumstance can also affect your management style. Theory X, for instance, is generally prevalent in large organizations or in teams where work can be repetitive and target driven. So in places where the work is repetitive and target driven, in such organizations, Theory X can be applied by the manager. Because in these cases, people are unlikely to find reward or fulfillment in their work. So a carrot and stick approach, meaning a combination of rewards and punishment, will tend to be more successful in motivating them than a theory Y approach. In contrast, theory Y tends to be favored by organizations that have a flatter structure and where lower level people are involved in decision making. So in a flatter structure, whoever are there in this lower level, and if they have to take some decisions and have some responsibility, then for them what is more suitable is theory Y. However, both theories have their own challenges. This was the end of the video. I hope you like my video, and if you have liked it, please don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up. Also, subscribe my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon besides the subscribe tab, because this will send you a notification whenever I upload a new video. Please share this video with your friends and family. Let me know your feedback and your thoughts in the comment section below. I also have my email address written down below. Till then, stay tuned with my channel and take care. Bye-bye.